So great to be here, man. Extra was shit, to be honest. There's loads of rah-rah-rah type pieces, you know.
Oh, man, tell me about it. I hate those geezers.
It's literally impossible to spend more than the 20 in here.
Ah!
Nice one.
Now, listen, young bagman.
There are things that I must teach you if you are to succeed here in the land of the £2 pint.
The cheat codes for north of Hendon.
You see, the northerner is trusting and loyal, like a gun dog. But when riled, become mistrustful and easily confused, like a sort of angry hen.
Now, you must also learn their tongue. Out is any, nout is none, tar is thanks, mint is good, tea is supper, dinner is lunch, a balm cake is a sort of bap, a bap is a tit, and a tit is a tit. Now, the northerner is a friendly sort by nature, but will become irascible if they feel taunted. So until you have ascertained their level, it's very important to pretend to be one of their own.
All right, Arcade, will you take us down Withington for a quid?
JP, is he a cabbie?
They're all cabbies in the North, Giles, for a price.
What up, K-Dubs? You came back.
For every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction, JP.
Yeah. Pussy man, I think some muff's got stuck on your chin.
What, this old thing? I've always had this, haven't I?
No.
I get it. You're peacocking. Billy Goat Muff. New term, new image.
I'm just letting it do its thing. A thing is as a thing does.
That's that. This is one of those. That carries on up there. Don't know what that does. In there's what you think. That's fucked. This makes a weird noise, but if you smack it, stops for a bit. This doesn't close, that doesn't open. It always smells like that up here. And this would be yours.
Free meat. Perks of the job.
Your job?
Yeah, part-time with the abattoir now.
Abattoir? How surprising. Yeah, what actually is it?
It's spare meat from the loose meat bin. It's okay. Some animals in that.
But which?
Oh, hark at the gourmand. I don't know. A little bit of this, a little bit of that. Grab a handful, fry it up. Meetabix.
Hello, losers. Everyone, Heather, everyone. We met on practical week. She's a mental dental, my new Bezzy, and we're forming a clique.
A clique?
Yeah. We'll be forming an in-group and ridiculing outsiders.
Hey, JC.
Oh, you're back.
Yeah, just Newtonian, you know?
Right. Is there something wrong with your face?
I'm just letting it do its thing. A thing is as a thing does.
Look, I just wanted to say, new term, clean slate. I've got a new mate. You've got a new... that. And...
it's cool, honey.
Honey.
We don't need a new slate. There's nothing wrong with the old slate. Everything just is what it is, so why stress anything?
Are you all right, Kingsley? Have you had a fall?
I've always yoed.
No, you haven't.
I'm off to see Professor Shales. How do I look?
Hot. What? It's a scientific fact.
Right. This is, Sabine. Just hear about the room. Sabine, everyone.
Hello. Yes, now I would like to check your water pressure and smoke alarms.
go crazy.
The room?
Yeah. Paul Wan, the invisible man, moved out over Christmas.
Unless we get someone new by the end of the week, our rent goes up 100 quid. Oh, saw her in the union, looking at room ads. She looked like a human.
No way! We'll just all pay extra. We don't need a newbie. Let's just turn the upstairs room into a massive bong.
I'm not paying extra.
Bong.
We should advertise.
Bong.
We should interview.
Bong.
So the water pressure seems to be okay, but you seem to have a problem with vermin. If you can murder the vermin, I will consider you.
Bong.
Oregon?
Hi. Thank you for applying for the internship at Rhombus.
Take a seat. So, tell me a little about yourself.
We met, obviously. You remember me from the,
From the fucking my husband?
Yes. Now, I was thinking more why I should pick you to help me launch a literary press, which is going to be so highbrow, the readers are going to resemble Dan Aykroyd's famous Coneheads.
Right. Okay. Lots of reasons. It's all over, by the way.
I know. Tony tried to climb in through the conservatory over Christmas.
Oh, Jesus, yeah, he called me. He was in a bit of a bad way.
He put his foot through a pane. I bandaged him up and let him come for lunch.
Oh, good.
I'm with Lyle now, so it was very, very difficult for Tony. We played an extremely aggressive game of Boggle and called it a night. So...
Yes. I just wanted to say, I'll be the best intern you've ever, ever, ever had. Cut me, Professor Shales, and I bleed the dream of a powerhouse of contemporary verse that links not only with the ivory tower, but the working man with his Xbox or the shopwoman in her soiled nightclothes.
Well, I'll put you on the short list with all the candidates who haven't humped the hubby, and we'll take it from there, good?
So, the plan is, we smoke the bong until we have two bongs. The bong, or bong one, and then a second bong. The room, or bong two.
So, you take a hit from the bong?
And then you think, relief, but no.
Bang, room bong.
And that's when, poo-tang, you get hit by the original bong, bong one, the actual bong again.
I have no desire to give my body a massive chemical insult this evening. Thank you.
If you're not going to smoke the bong, then why are you in here?
Because it's warmer in here. Due to all the body heat you lot are so wantingly giving away.
If we get high enough, we generally have an orgy.
We generally don't.
We might. It's impossible to predict what might happen in the bong room. Cockcat can make people incredibly horny.
Interesting work. Have you ever attempted a fifth penis emanating from the tail?
It's a brilliant idea. Yes. A tail cock.
Don't stick my oar in, and I know you're a woman in your own right. It's just...
It's okay. You can speak freely within the clique.
The posho. JP. Sort of been there, done that.
Oh, so hands off?
God, no, no, no. It's just... It's not that he's a shithead. It's more that he's a dickhead.
Yeah.
My house. Bit of a mess. We're back.
We're just doing the advert.
Oh, okay, good. Let's draw up a list of criteria.
Cold and hot. Not too hot. Life's hard enough.
Just put, if you like to fuck... Then come and suck on our heroin stick.
No.
Not a bad start.
All we want is someone clean and fun. So put
Vodka by night, antibacterial mouthwash by morning is a headline.
Look, forget about your shitty ad.
Hey!
Call off the hunt. Stop all the clocks. You want a roomie? I've got you a roomie. Giles. Giles will move it.
Who's Giles?
He's a stoic.
Like me, he subscribes to the teachings of the philosopher Zeno.
No, Howard. He meant to stay with me. Look, Giles will just crash here whilst he finds himself a place.
Giles. From Stowe.
No, I don't think so, JP.
Yeah, sorry, that doesn't sound cool.
You haven't even met him. He's an amazing laugh. He once pulled a Mooney on Leaver's Eve while smoking 3 Marley Lights.
We've already got one, JP. We don't need another one.
We don't want a posh top floor.
Listen, Melissa. Just because Giles is a little bit posh doesn't necessarily mean he's not a bloody good bloke.
What sort of posh? Like, is he more cunty Sykes or racist Ralph, would you say?
Ralph is not racist. You know, if anything, you're the racists. The worst kind of racists. Money racists.
Sorry?
Yeah. Being rich is a race too.
No, it's not. I don't know, they do all look kind of the same.
Are you seriously saying that something that I want isn't going to happen because of you?
You got any lunch after?
Yeah. Although, actually, that reminds me. Can I borrow some notes?
Yeah. 20 quid?
Actually, I was thinking more like 180.
Yeah.
It's just I've spunked my RAF money. I'm about to hit my overdraft like an angry bastard. But I've got a cheque coming on Tuesdays.
OK, yeah, great. 180. I'll go to a cash point. Yeah. But...
Back to the scene of the crime. Good holidays, I trust. I have to say, I missed you all tremendously when I attempted to remember your names. So, apologies for the last-minute email, but what did everyone think of your holiday reading? Autumn feelings.
Didn't read it.
Well, maybe you should have read it because it's your coursework.
It's basically a self-help book.
It's a rather incredible selection of reflections on love across the generations.
I thought we were meant to be studying the Grapes of Wrath.
I see. Are you all afraid of having your minds opened up? Ah, you prefer your little boxes. Black goes with black, white with white, girl with boy, 48-year-old with 48-year-old. There's a world beyond the curriculum, you know. A world beyond the conventional world you're all so desperate to inhabit, where everything is wild and free. The world of autumn feelings.
So, you did posho and soul patch.
Yeah, it was a weird term. I was drinking a lot of Red Bull.
But you definitely don't like either of them.
What? No. God. I mean, Patch Adams is like, oh, let's listen to Ed Sheeran and talk about our feelings because I'm so much like a virgin, I actually am one, but really just an asshole. Same again?
So, what did everyone think about Liam?
Who's Liam?
For the room. The man who I think's my friend from the abattoir.
You think he's your friend?
Well, we sit together at lunch, but we don't talk.
He's the quiet type.
Was he the one who walked the house in a kind of intense silence?
Very wiry.
Exactly. He's ideal. He's wiry and quiet and efficient.
New housemate requested. Wiry, stealthy psychopath preferred.
Giles?
Sabine?
What, that mental Dutch woman in her 40s? How come you love Sabine all of a sudden?
Vod told her that we'd pay all the rent to her. In cash.
She's gonna be my beer bitch.
Great.
Oh my God, this is amazing. Jean wants me to pick up De Valensis. The poet? From the airport? Oh, it's at 6:30 a.m.
You're Jean's poetry bitch.
What about Heather? I mean, she's dying to move out of halls and she's a really great laugh. Today. In class, we had this demonstration model, and she switched the molars and premolars.
How come Josie's allowed to have a friend move in, but I'm not? And look, the thing about Giles is that he's not even that posh.
J. Venus! So... Toga! Toga! Toga!
Great work with the glass village. All pillage, no spillage.
Sorry, I don't speak posh.
Well,
Welcome to your first Banty Natal class. I'm your tutor, Bantonio Banteras.
Can you not wear your coat at breakfast, Howard?
Why?
It's covered in stuff.
It's covered in reality.
Is everything all right down the abattoir?
Oh, yeah. Another good night shift. On my own in the Red Room for most of it.
It's just you look like you've seen the slaughter at Helm's Deep.
I'm sorry?
Sauron, Lord of the Rings.
Never read it, never seen it.
Fuck off!
Why do people always assume I have an intimate knowledge of made-up beasties?
Morning. Oh, morning. You stayed over then?
Yeah.
In JP's room. I didn't hear anything.
JP? Oh, no way.
Heather, do you want a coffee or a portion of mashed tissue sweepings all fried up?
Well, I ought to go back to my place and change, so...
Okay, then. Thank you.
Thank you.
And farewell.
See you in clinical skills, mate.
See you then, mate.
Mega Toga.
Toga Maximus.
Toga Togissimus.
Do you know Veritas?
Nota Bene. Oh, dude.
I think I might take a shower.
Oh, word of warning on the water pressure, boy. That thing's flow is as weak as a sucker MC with adenoids.
You need a power shower, man. What?
Power showers? Like in Warpole?
Oh, fuck. I'd forgotten.
Probably for the best. I mean, it was all dorm rules. No speaky, no squeaky.
He shoots, he scores.
Oh, bloody hell. Yeah. Strange days.
Well, it was fun though, wasn't it?
Yeah, fun. If you're a bender.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, come on. I mean, I know it was only power showers and it was all dorm rules. But if you think about it, it was a bit fucking gay.
Yeah, don't. You know, there's
no need. Don't be a homo!
Well, JP, the thing is, mate, I am a homo.
Da, Gaylord!
Seriously, man.
Don't bend me, queeroid!
I am! I'm gay.
Stop saying it, you'll turn gay.
Well, I am gay.
Yeah, well, I'm gay too! Yeah! I'm glad to be gay! What a gay day!
Yeah, I'm actually gay there.
Dude, this one is getting kind of old now.
Yeah, I'm gay, JP. I like men.
What? You don't actually mean you are gay?
Yes, I'm gay.
Fuck. Seriously?
Yeah, I'm gay. I've always been gay. The power showers.
The power showers weren't gay.
What, wanking each other off?
Don't say it! Dude, no need to say it.
Look, it's okay, JP. For you, it was just a stage. For me, it was the whole deal.
Oh, farewell. Jesus.
I like the handshake. The reassuring handshake of completed sexual union.
Weird one. I was just so drunk.
Oh, you don't have to. It's fine.
Why wouldn't it be fine?
It wouldn't, that's why I said it's fine.
Okay. Great. Yeah, it was no biggie anyway, it was just a thing.
Yeah. She's had her man meet. She's moving on.
Man meet?
Where do I get my platter of man meat tonight, she's always saying.
Right. Yeah?
Go on, I can take it.
Just sort of... good quarter pounder of man meat last night. Want to help me look for a half pound tonight? That girl.
Has anybody got a massive bottle of Tippex? I'm painting every cock cat. I don't know why I drew it. I mean, no one wants to see that, do they? Five penises. Why did I even draw that?
I don't know.
Exactly.
Yeah, so I was just wondering if it was a problem if I got back that cashola. Not been a hard ass or anything,
no,
but...
No, I actually wanted to talk to you about that. You know, it's a weird one. The cheque did come, but not as a cheque. As a postal order, because Dave hasn't got an account. But it's better, you know, because he's there.
Good.
Oh, but now Mike, who owed it, I fucked his moped for him in June. I mean, he thought it was, but it wasn't.
Insured?
Exactly. So now I have to pony up half, and his other half is on a power key of our mate. So when that's sweet, get the next appointments and his spare cash all round. Is that cool?
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, totally, that's...
Cool.
Oregon. Jean, hi. So sorry I was late. De Valensis was quite insistent that we drive past Paul Scholes' house and honk the horn, and took us a while to find it.
He's delighted. I'm delighted. Oregon, I'd like you to help me launch Rhombus Literary Press.
Yes! Oh, you will not regret this, Jean.
Oregon, what are you... Can I grab a word?
She's all yours.
Yes, it's just about your attendance. You missed this morning's lecture.
Yeah, sorry, I couldn't make it.
Right. So, you openly admit to having missed a scheduled lecture.
Oh, Tony. I picked up De Valensis from the airport for Jean.
I can't just turn a blind eye to non-attendance, you know. This is a serious matter.
Oh, I missed one lecture.
You missed two in November.
I was in Buxton with you in November.
I'm minded to refer you to the disciplinary council. This could all go very badly for you. Unless we can come to a satisfactory conclusion to the matter.
Are you trying to blackmail me into having sex with you?
What a terrible thing to say.
You raised your eyebrows.
Even if I did, which I didn't. Eyebrows don't mean sex.
Tony, we're over.
We can't be over if we're not. If a thing continues, it is. Therefore, I am and we are.
Yeah, I want you to delete my number from your phone.
Fine, I can delete your number. Because it's branded into my heart anyway. So, Jean, you've traded up, switched horses.
It's nothing personal. I just want to make something of my time here. And I'm passionate about poetry.
I know you are. Fuck. I used to read you E.E. Cummings while you rested your head on my naked chest and we'd both weep, and those were the best days of my life.
Yeah. Thanks. Oh, I better go, because I want to get a baked potato, and if you go late, then you get the really hard ones.
Now, has he said anything? You know... about me and the other night.
What, Kingsley? No, not really.
Oh, okay.
Do you like him?
I don't know. He's... I don't know about him. What do you think?
You do know his nickname's the Pussy Man, don't you?
Really?
Yeah. There's two sides to him. He's Russell Brand on the inside and Russell Grant on the outside. Comes over all sensitive and happy to talk about horoscopes, but really he just wants to fuck you, chuck you, and gloat about it to your granddad.
I mean, did he say anything about me after, or...?
I don't know, I can't remember.
Go on.
Maybe something like... guess I'll start looking for a new hairy parking space for the old cockmobile. Something like that, maybe not exactly that.
You know what? That was my one thing. Is he a bit wet?
What?
I like a challenge. I know it's stupid, but I do like a bit of a bastard.
Really?
I know it's a bit of a cliche, but I do. That's just what I like.
JP.
Thanks.
Howard?
Thanks, Giles.
No bother.
So, not to be uncool, but I think we need to call a house meeting about the room.
Whew. Well, I guess Heather's the front runner.
Yeah. But you know what? Giles is actually a pretty decent bloke. He's surprisingly all right.
He's incredibly all right.
I better split. The rent's coming up to help me look for a place, so, see you later.
Oh, Giles, I've got something for you. Offcuts from the abattoir. It's the meat they don't sell. It's loose. Jazz meat. It's not all tubed up like the other meat. It's just relaxing, doing its own thing. It doesn't need anyone telling it what shape to be.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
The good thing is it's so processed you hardly need to chew. It's melt in the mouth. And there's a lot more where that came from.
Okay. Thanks. Javester.
Okay.
Laters, guys.
Great, Howard. We almost had a wicked new housemate.
And free meat will seal the deal.
I mean, it's cool because, you know, I guess Heather was sort of first in line anyway, so...
That is true. Also, Heather just seems very chilled, you know?
Yeah. Heather on tap for Knutsford.
Yeah, right. I don't care either way. I just think she's got a nice vibe.
You've gone from Mr. No Strings one-night stand to basically wanting to move in together.
Oh, bullshit! I have one-night stands. That's how I roll. I'm a guy with a cock. She's a girl with a slot. We just happened to lock together one night.
Ah, the romance.
Giles, Heather. At the end of the day, guys, they're both just people. I say just go with the flow. Let Heather move in and then I'm sure everything will sort itself out.
I don't know, though. It's actually really tricky because, as it turns out, I really like Giles. And to be honest, I've had second thoughts about Heather. I'm just not sure that I want to live with such a great mate. I mean, wouldn't it be unfair on everyone else?
Same goes for Giles, actually.
What?
Well, I mean, come on. Do you want us permanently doing... Do you remember when Sykes got his fencing mask and turned up to Olympic trials wearing a sieve?
Whoa! A sieve? That is mad. Personally, I would love to hear more stories like that.
Plus... It's awkward, but there's something else I need to tell you about Giles. He... steals. Yeah, he steals. He loves to thieve. Must be like a psychological thing. He's like the opposite of a retard.
Don't say that.
Well, I'm not saying retard, am I? I'm saying he's the opposite of a retard, Kingsley.
It's always been.
No.
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 Well, you've missed out on Liam.
Oh, no.
Yep. He's found somewhere extremely close to the abattoir.
Is this new?
Yeah. Why?
I just thought the next point's the moped.
Yeah, it was in a sale, all right, Mum?
God.
Oh, look, as it happens, I actually need to spot a tenner to stand my round.
Great, so, now I'm your beer bitch.
Oh, come on, just put it on the tab.
We don't have a tab.
Yeah, we do. I'm keeping a tab.
I'm learning it like a punched quiche. Oh, Kingsnake, heads up. It's wifey.
She's coming over.
I say, strike while the iron's hot and ask her to marry you.
Oh, fuck off.
If you like it, then it's probably advisable to put a ring on it.
My hair?
Hey, Joyce. Hello.
Do you want to join us?
Oh, I'd love to. It's just I'm with Jan, so, you know. Great to see you.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, man, that was cold.
Turns out Mr. Soft-Spreading Cheese actually has the cold, hard eyes of a killer.
Oh, anyone for another? I'm buying.
Mine's a Jaeger.
That's my money she's using at Bibles. I'm the one buying you that drink, and everyone else's.
What do you mean?
I lent Lord 40 quid last week, but it turns out to reclaim it, I've got to travel to a house in Utoxa and hit an electricity meter with a hammer.
God,
That was awkward.
Yeah, it was a bit.
Still, bollocks to him. There's plenty more cock in the sea. And now that the team's back together, we can go cock fishing all night and all day.
Yeah.
That's the entertainment.
Okay, man. I've got a bit of a thought in the old head in that, mate.
Right.
Yeah, it's about Giles.
Yeah, you seem really down on him. Did something happen?
Yeah, sort of. See, thing is, it turns out that he's gay.
Right.
But I didn't know, so...
So you've turned against him. Oh, that's nice. That's charming.
No, you don't understand.
I think I do understand. You've gone from liking to hating someone because of their sexual choices.
Mate, I just want him to be normal.
Oh, normal?
Lay off. I'm not the one on trial here.
It's just sex, JP. It's just one man having sex with another man because they both feel like it. And what's wrong with that?
I'm not homophobic. I had sex with Giles. That's how not homophobic I am.
You've had sex with Giles?
Yeah, well, not proper sex. Just a power shower.
A power shower?
You know, extreme washing.
All right.
But, I mean, we were both, like, 14, so it doesn't really count. But now he's saying that, like, he's properly gay. Like, he'd go to a gay club not in disguise, or he'd, you know, grow a moustache and have a baby. And all that makes me think is, does that mean that I'm gay? I mean... I had gay sex with a gay guy. Does that make me gay?
Gay sex with a gay guy.
Oh, God. You think I'm gay, don't you?
I didn't say that. And if you were, it wouldn't bother me.
Oh, shit. You're tolerating me. You're tolerating my gayness. This is a nightmare.
JP, relax. It's cool.
I mean, I don't feel gay. But then how do you know? I don't want to bum you, but then maybe I do. Cockcat. Oh, shit. Maybe I'm in denial. But why does it make me feel so scared and angry?
Maybe you're bi-furious.
Okay. How about me and you and Josie all turn the lights out and I'm blindfolded and I touch you both up to see which one of you gets the old juices flowing?
Right. You fuck me, then Josie, then me again, just to double check. Sort of like we're fuck monkeys in your sex lab.
It's just an idea.
All right, kid Babylonians, guess what? I bumped into Paula and hit her up for a fiver, so chips all round. What's going on? What's happened? Did someone die?
We wanted to have a talk with you about money.
Yeah?
Yeah. When we chatted, it turns out, we've all been lending you money.
Except me.
We've added it all up, and it comes to £354 in total.
I've drawn up a 6-month repayment plan. It's a basis for discussion.
This is bullshit! Mates lend each other money!
Vod, this isn't personal. These are times of financial uncertainty. You're one of the big 6 economies in this house. If you collapse, you'll take us all down.
I can't believe I'm living with a bunch of bean counters.
Yeah, we've counted and you've got all our beans.
Borrowed. I've borrowed your fucking beans, Jesus. You lot, you want to have a long, hard look at yourself.
There was one place with the room free, but it was not great. And it was like, it was a right of way through the room for a Portuguese family. But apparently they either don't go out much or don't come in much, but either way. You okay, JP?
Yeah, fine. Totally fine.
Might jump in the shower if you want. You could...
I'm fine.
Go first, if you want.
No, You go ahead.
JP, I'm not going to try and bum you, you know.
Look, I'm not a bloody homophobe, all right? I've only been involved at amateur level, not professional like you. But it's all fine. It's totally fine.
Gay men don't necessarily want to have sex with every guy they see.
Yeah, sure.
Really?
Come on, Giles. You have to say that. But really?
Well, it's like you with women. Do you want to bang them all?
Yeah, pretty much. Well, all the hotties.
Yeah, I suppose I want to bang all the hotties too.
So I'm right. You do want to bum me.
Well, say, like, in your house. Oregon. Do you want to bang her?
Interesting. Fascinating question. This is like philosophy or something, because I've thought about it a lot. And it's like, yeah, I mean, I definitely would, but it's like we sort of live together and I kind of like her, so maybe no, or not no. It's complicated, because she's like a friend, so it'd be really weird.
Yeah. Well, that's kind of like how I'd say it was for me with a mate.
Okay. Wow. Well, this is great. I'm over here in the bed, straight. You're over there, with no trousers on. Gay. And that's fine.
Good night, John Boy.
You don't want to bum me? And I don't want to bum you. That's fine. So nobody has to bum anybody. That's my credo. The freedom to bum or not to bum. I'll put that on my flag one day when I get around to making it.
Oh, I've had a big think, and I reckon you lot might not be total arseholes about the money after all. I'm not saying I'm wrong, and if you want me to, you can take a flying fucking jump, because I was always going to pay you back, but I'm going to pay my debt to society with stuff. Start sifting.
I really don't think that's necessary.
Great with me.
There's no knickers.
Why do people always assume I have a prurient interest in underwear?
Take those trainers, know you like them.
No, I don't want your trainers.
Pick up the trainers, Oregon.
Okay.
Okay, listen, everyone. I've got an announcement to make. This is Giles, my gay friend. He doesn't want to bum me, and I don't want to bum him. And I don't care who knows it. And he's moving in.
That's lovely, JP. There's just one catch. We called Sabine last night and offered her the room.
Well, call her back. Tell her she can't have it. This house is going by curious.
Uh-oh.
She's really ringing. Just wait it out.
It doesn't feel great. I think you just have to push through the embarrassment barrier.
Yeah, this is a cool house. We do not need some freak spoiling our vibe.
There is one thing, though.
Shh! Odd. She's gonna go.
Connor gave her a key.
Hello?
I thought they were gonna get it.
Yeah, we all thought somebody else was gonna get it.
Could somebody lend a hand? Not literally, to help me move my stuff up to my room.
Listen, Sabine, the thing is, and this is hard to explain, there's been a bit of a mix-up, and we'd love for you to move in, but it's not going to be possible, because...
But it was agreed I have the key.
What do you think?
No! No, I won't stand for this. It's political correctness gone mad. I'm sorry, Sabine, but we have a gay man moving in. So although it may seem xenophobic, it's not. Because we have someone even, well, not weirder, but more different. So, hard cheese.
But I've signed a rental agreement.
Oh, dear, oh, dear. Your English isn't very good, is it? We want Giles to move in.
But I want to live here.
Yes, but, and I'm sorry to say this, the truth is that none of us want you to live here.
It's not that we don't like you. Obviously, we don't really know you. We just think we won't like you.
Why won't you like me? I'm a nice person. Anyway, this house is much larger than the other houses. It's conveniently located. The transport links are excellent. And I've already told my bank about my change of address.
What should we do? Should we take her down?
Yes. Let's take her down.
You're not going to take her down.
Thus far, then none shall pass.
Lord of the Rings?
Holy Grail. None shall pass. She passed.
The next Fresh Meat, next Tuesday from 10. Series 1 is out on DVD with some meaty extras. Order your copy at channel4.com/shop. A change to some listings next on 4, and a good one too. Any opportunity to see Homeland must be taken with both hands. Carry on the Run. And coming up.